What's up guys, it's Hiro here, and today we're going to be reading the patch notes for Absolver 1.10 update, which actually happened November 10th. I'm sorry I'm late, I've been kind of busy, but I'm actually really interested in what happened in these patch notes, so I figured you would be too, and if you don't want to read them, well, I'm here for you. Also, another thing to mention is that after I read the patch notes, I actually want to talk about 3v3 a little bit, because I have a want of how I would like for it to work. And I don't know, I just want to talk about it and see what you guys think. But anyways, let's read the patch notes. So basically, they lowered the XP gains when defeating a level 3 boss and beyond, which this is probably primarily towards, what's her name, Rissaren, based on the fact that everyone was going up there and just farming her for levels, which to me is kind of boring, but I mean, if it's viable, you do you. But they lowered the XP for it, so I don't know how viable it is now. Supposedly, people are saying the XP still feels the same. It's not like a dramatic difference. But with me saying that, I hope they don't try to nerf it even more. I feel like it's, I don't know, I feel like it's fair, you know? If you want to level through PvE, you can. If you want to fight one boss all day, even though it's boring, you can do it. It's whatever. Higher XP gains in combat trials. Once again, I think it's 100% primarily towards the little farming versus Rissaren. Basically says, hey man, if you want to level up faster, you probably should just do PvP. Because it's a PvP game, which I completely agree. Cost of Rift Discs have changed to 5 crystals, which, you know, I've actually gotten a taste of this, and I kind of don't like it. I liked having 3, but once again, it's a game where getting more fashion for your character is kind of awesome. So, I don't know, having to do a little bit more just to get it, I'm okay with that. It's not a big deal. It's not a huge change. Like, getting 5 crystals compared to 3, it's not going to be dramatic. That's like one day of grinding. Now I got 30 Rift Discs. Let's go, you know. Marked ones have now been reverted to their original form, which means Halloween masks are now available only through Rift Discs, which is perfectly fine. Once again, they did the same thing for the, what was it? I think it was like the 1.07 update, or it was either the 1.06 update, where they basically put a whole bunch of masks behind the, basically the map in the starter area. Now you can only get them through Rift Discs as well, which is perfectly fine, once again. And a little bit above these update patch notes, it basically lets people know, hey, you know, we've been working on the 3v3 game mode and basically adding features to the equipment and, essence, menus. The next thing that I'm about to say actually makes me pretty excited, such as allowing players to choose the color of their equipment. What? I'm excited! Or acquiring specific weapons and gear with fragments. And if you guys have already forgotten about fragments, basically, remember how when you salvage gear, you would get something so you could basically repair armor if it was broken? Yeah. Well, now you could use those fragments towards gear. So, I'm wondering if we're gonna have like a shop system, or are we gonna have, I don't know, I'm just wondering how this system is gonna get into play. I don't know, I think it'll open a lot more variety in terms of colors and stuff, and we'll actually kind of get an idea of how much equipment is actually in the game. Now, I want you guys to keep this topic in mind, because I want to talk about this in the future as well. But yeah, they also say that there will probably be another small update before 3v3 is actually live. This update will include an anti-cheat system, which I will clap to that 100%. I haven't been against a lot of cheaters, but supposedly there is a lot of cheaters. I've literally only been against one cheater, and it's when I was newer to the game. And after that, I have not seen any. So, I guess cheating is actually not fun in this game. So, I don't know what to say about that. Now, if you guys remember earlier in the video, I said I wanted to talk about the fragment system and the 3v3 game mode that's coming in the future. So when it comes to the fragments, my biggest question is it going to be a die system, or is it going to be like a shop where we just buy different types of gear? Ooh, or will it be one of those things where if you acquire a certain piece of gear, you basically can buy certain colors with fragments? That would be cool. So if you get duplicates, you could just change the color of that duplicate rather than having to get rid of it and get fragments for it. That would be cool. That would be cool. Maybe you waste fragments to get that different color. Smart. Just saying. Just thinking. Outside the box. That's a question I really want to know, and I want you guys to let me know in the comment section on which one you would prefer. The other question I have for you guys is, how do you want 3v3s to work? Personally, I'm hoping it's a tag team type system, and I'm really, really hoping it's not just, hey, yeah, you guys just get thrown into an arena together, 3 people, and you guys just fight. If that's the case, I'm going to be kind of disappointed. That's all I can really say. I can't really think on how they'll add 3v3s, so I'm really hoping it's just something unique and different, and it's something that just really surprises us, because they kind of surprised us with all the other updates, so I don't know what to think. But anyways, yeah, let me know what you guys think down in the comment section below, and that is basically it for this video. If you want more patch updates like this, let me know down in the comment section below. You can like the video if you want. I'm not gonna judge you, but I am. Yeah, stay frosty, and there's more to come.